Grand Teton National Park is home to several small glaciers nestled among the high peaks. These glaciers not only contribute to alpine scenery and recreation, but they also provide critical habitat and water for alpine ecosystems, for animals like pikas, marmots, and black rosy finches, and for hikers and climbers. Across Wyoming, glacial meltwater is a significant contribution to the Snake and Green Rivers, which provide water for irrigation. Each year, park scientists survey Middle Teton Glacier to assess how quickly the ice is disappearing. The better science we have, the better we can understand the effects of climate change on this park and work to be responsible stewards.
It's impossible to imagine the Tetons without glaciers, because without glaciers, there really wouldn't be the Tetons. You know, there certainly was this massive uplift that brought all of the rock we're surrounded by up, but the sculpting of that rock that makes the Tetons so famous, I mean, that's glaciers right there.
There may be as many as 11 glaciers in the Tetons. To be an active glacier, the ice has to be flowing downhill under its own weight. And some of our glaciers have lost enough ice volume that they're probably not active anymore. They're probably not flowing. Studying glaciers is critical because they're really sensitive indicators of climatic trends. And the health of a glacier is basically determined by the balance between winter snowpack and how much of that melts during the summer, so summer temperatures. Whether the ice is advancing or retreating is basically determined by the last 1, 5, 10, maybe more years of climate.
Well, we're studying these glaciers to see both what the size is, the current size, the depth, and then also to have a marker of change over time, because they obviously are changing and unfortunately shrinking. This is my second year doing the glacier survey. The first year we were out at Schoolroom Glacier, and the last 2 years we've been here at the Middle Teton Glacier.
And then there are some reference points kind of just to the lookers left of those crevasses.
It's nice to have the intersection between what we do as climbing rangers and science and resource management and naturalists all come together to share information, and we all rely on each other's skills to make things like this happen.
Today, we're trying to measure the surface of the glacier, the vertical surface, and we have a grid that we have predetermined to give us kind of an idea where to measure.
We're trying to get an accurate elevation model within 10 inches.
We take reference point measurements using the same equipment, and the reference points are scattered in key places along the glacier, and we go exactly as best we can to that same point to get the best vertical measurement.
And this is my favorite glacier in the park, actually. Coming here for 30 years to climb, it's something you always see, I've always seen. Even the permanent snow fields that exist, like on Owen and Tiwanaut, to see those get smaller and smaller. And if they ever went away, it would be dramatic visual change.
And it's a rarity to have glaciers in the lower 48, so I think it's a treat for people to come and be able to actually see a glacier in fairly close proximity. You know, even from the road, they can look up at Mount Moran and up into the Cathedral Group and see glaciers, which a lot of people don't get that opportunity. It's a constant reminder for me, too, of how things are changing, and that terrible fact that we may lose these glaciers entirely at the rate climate change is occurring.